My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on applied data science with Python. This is lecture number 266. In this lecture, I will continue my discussion on Amazon Fine Food Reviews dataset. Now we will try to understand average vote vec and TFIDF vote vec code samples. We will try to understand simple Python code. But before understanding this lecture, I request you to go through lecture number 259, in which I discussed about these two concepts, average vote vec and TFIDF vote vec. In this lecture, we will try to understand n-grams, bigrams and TFIDF by using Jupyter Notebook, which we discussed in previous lectures. So, as we understood average vote vec, basically, given a sentence, we want to compute vote vec for each sentence and take simple average. That's what I discussed in lecture number 259. I have written here, so for each sentence, just observe this one, for each sentence in list of sentences, this TQDM I already discussed, which indicates this progressive bar, isn't it? Just go through my previous lecture, in which lectures in which I discussed about this particular TQDM. Now let me say, so for each sentence, for each sentence in list underscore of underscore sentences. What is this list of underscore of sentences? I already discussed in previous lectures. Therefore, I can say for each sentence in the list of sentences, for each word in the sentence. Just see, for each word in the sentence, isn't it? I am computing vote vec. Just see, I am computing vote vec. This vote vec is my, I am computing the vote vec using my own vote vec representation. This is our own vote vec representation. Just recall this vote vec we built in previous lectures, is in previous lecture. Therefore, I can say I am computing vote vec using my own vote vec representation. I am adding into the sentence vector. That's what it says. Just see, I am adding into the sentence vector. So initially, I initialize sentence vector to 0. Just see, sentence underscore vec np dot zeros. We know what is np dot zeros. In initial class itself, I discussed in Python programming. I keep adding it to sentence vector. Just see, I am keep adding into sentence vector, isn't it? I divide by number of words. Just see, sentence vectors by, I am dividing with count of words, is it not? It's a very, very simple implementation of average vote vec. Very, very straightforward. Try to walk through this code. It is simple, and this code you can understand yourself. Similarly, I can compute TFIDF vote vec. For that, I need to get TFIDF weight for each word, isn't it? I need weight. How can I calculate? Once I have my TFIDF vector, just see, this is model equal to TFIDF vectorizer, model.fit. We know what is TFIDF vectorizer. We have seen the documentation in previous lectures. Even we have seen fit function. I'm applying to this pre-processed reviews. Now I am creating dictionary. We are converting a dictionary with word as a key. Just see, word as a key and the IDF as value, isn't it? Now TFIDF underscore feature, TFIDF words, I can get TFIDF of features, I can say of words, or I can say column names. This is TFIDF word to vec vector for each sentence, basically it's a list. This one can understand. It is simple and straightforward. Here, just see what we are doing. Sentence underscore vec equal to sentence underscore vec plus you are weighted. We are waiting with TF-IDF. Just see, we are multiplying with TF-IDF values with vectors, isn't it? Finally, that one we are dividing with weighted sum. Just see, sentence vector we are dividing with weighted sum. It is simple and straightforward code. Anybody can understand. Just try to imitate previous slide. Basically, here we are multiplying with TF-IDF weight, nothing more than that. It is simple and straightforward. Anybody can understand. Now we will go to our Jupyter notebook and we will see that code, how it works. Just see this one. I already executed this particular code. Just see this one. Yes, this is bigrams and n-grams code. This I already discussed. This, just see, count vectorizer n-gram underscore range equal to 1 comma 2. We will get unigrams as well as bigrams. Min underscore df, max underscore features. I told you that I will discuss in a separate lecture in natural language process classes. This one is fit underscore transform for pre-processed reviews. This I already shown in our PowerPoint presentation in previous lectures. Just I am displaying, just see, the type of count vectorizer. Just see the type of counter vectorizer. What type of vectorizer it is? Basically, it is a sparse matrix, isn't it? The shape, how can I display? Final underscore bigram underscore counts get shape. Get shape method is used to get the shape. What is this final underscore bigram counts? This one. After fit underscore transform, I will get that one. Shape is 4986, 3144 means there are 4986 rows and 3144 columns are features. There are 3144 features. The number of unique words and unigrams and bigrams, how will I get shape of one, isn't it? The how many unigrams, bigrams you are having? 3144. Same thing here also display. Just I already executed. Why? Because it takes time to execute. That's why I executed this code and I'm showing this one. Again, this is TF-IDF vectorizer, which we discussed on in our PowerPoint presentations in previous lectures, where n-gram underscore range equal to 1 comma 2 means you will get unigrams as well as bigrams. Forget about min underscore df. These things I will discuss in our natural language processing classes. Fit, I already discussed what is fit. Just see, some sample features. How will I get some sample features? Just see. Get feature underscore names, I'm slicing 0 to 10. Therefore, these are some sample features. What are the features? Some sample features. Ability is one feature. It is unigram. Able is another feature. Able find bigram. Able get is bigram. Absolute unigram. Absolutely unigram. Absolutely delicious. This is bigram. After that, print equal to star means I'm printing 50 equal to marks. What it says, the type of count vector, what is the type of count vectorizer? Final underscore TF underscore IDF. What it says, the type is basically it is a sparse one. That's what it says. The shape of the TF IDF, how will I get? There is a get shape method that I already discussed in previous lectures. What is the shape? That is, shape is 4986 rows and 3144 columns. The number of unique words, including both unigram and bigrams, that is essentially features. They are basically column names. That's what it says. Just the final underscore get shape of one means it will get number of column names. Even if you want, you can calculate TF-IDF values for features. These are the values. 7.11, this is TF-IDF. 4.55, this particular statement, this printf, I have not included in our PowerPoint presentation. Now you can see, you can find the TF-IDF values for all the features. This is word to vec. There are two types of word to vec. Either you can build your own word to vec, otherwise you can make use word to vec built by Google. Now we are building our own word to vec. This is simple list of sentences. This we already discussed. What is list of sentences? What am I doing? This is pre-processed reviews. From each review, I am collecting sentence and I am splitting into words. And all those words I am appending into list of sentences. This is a list of sentences. I am going to construct our own word to vec. Even if you want, you can use Google built-in word to vec. That I discussed in that lecture. Just see this one. This one is there are two types. This one is actually keyed vectors dot load word to vec format Google News. This I already discussed. Google News vectors and negative grams 300 bin. This is a word to vec built by Google by using their Google News. But even we can build our own word to vec. If you see this one, just see min underscore count equal 5. That I already discussed in my previous lecture. Just see this word to vec underscore model. This is our own word to vec. We are building this word to vec by using list of sentences. Even we discussed what is this min underscore count equal 5. Min underscore count basically says that if a word does not occur at least 5 times, don't construct word to vec for it. Similarly, size also I discussed. Basically, size means dimension of the vector. Size equal 50 means what? It is dimension of the vector. Workers equal 4. If you have multi-core box, set workers equal 4. It uses all the 4 cores in your box. It is simple and straightforward. I discussed most similar. What is most similar in those classes? This is word to vec built by Google, but I am using our own word to vec. This is the output. I am calculating similarity values. I already discussed that similarity values is always between 0 and 1, isn't it? 1 means most similar, 0 means no similarity. This is word to vec model. What it says, number of words, length means what is length, 3817. We already constructed word to vec means we are collected words which occurred minimum 5 times, isn't it? Some sample words I displayed here. This is the code I discussed in PowerPoint presentation in my previous lectures. This is average word to vec. Just in this lecture only I discussed this particular code. I already executed this code and I am showing output as if I keep on executing now, it will take time. That's why I executed this code for average word to vec. I executed in similar manner. I executed TF-IDF word to vec. As I told you, I will provide this IPython notebook after few classes as I am busy with recording these lectures. Just go through this lecture once. If you have any difficulty, please keep a comment so that I will try to explain. Thank you very much.